Okay, so I've got I got my own bag, and I've got my ball, and I've got my shoes. But there seems to be other pockets, and I don't know what else to put in them.
All right. So first of all, most bags, obviously, the ball goes interior.
Right.
And then you want to make sure you have a nice towel. Just one that's not really linty and that will leave a lot of trash all over your ball. And then it also works good when you're done with a game. We would recommend that you go home and you can do it at the alley, but maybe go home and give it a good spritz and clean because it's got oil and everything from the lanes on it.
And do you want to do that every, like after every game?
I think after every time you go bowling.
Okay.
Yeah. And then you did mention shoes. So I would highly recommend getting some shoe protectors. A big reason is when you come to an alley and you rent shoes, why would they have you rent shoes to be on the alley but then go in the bathroom, go up to the bar? So I would really recommend putting some slippers on your shoes when you're going to do those things.
Yeah, that's smart. I'll take some.
A lot of this stuff isn't expensive either. Okay, so one of your little pockets might have in it some tape. One reason I carry tape is when I play a game or two, my thumb starts to swell. So this tape makes my thumb a little bit slippery.
Uh-huh.
So it will help pull the ball off a little bit. It swells. Here we have some Ultra Slide, which is a powder that you just put your thumb in the bag, kind of powder it up, and we do it that way. We also have a resin ball, has a nice powder into it. Tack up the hands a little bit. I know this is another kind of tape that my husband wears. He likes to layer it up so the ball stays on better. This is a brush for your shoes. So if you do happen to walk around the bowling alley and something gets on it, or over time, they also tend to get flat. So this kind of helps rough them back up a little bit.
Okay.
Clean them off. Being a person that has fingernails, I also carry a file.
Yeah.
Fingernail clippers.
Yeah.
If you don't, how many times you've broken a nail?
Well, I bite mine down, but if you're a classy lady,
mine's my thumbnail.
Yeah.
Mine's my thumbnail.
Yeah.
So those, I think, are pretty much most of the essentials in my bag.
All right, so Thomas, you seem to know what you're doing a little bit more than I do, but you also seem to have a lot more in your bag.
Yep.
Shoe covers blew my mind.
Yep.
So I assume you have even more exciting stuff.
Yeah, there's actually, once you get into bowling, it's a rabbit hole you can go down very quickly.
Perfect.
So, just like Gretchen, shoe covers.
There they are.
Where Gretchen's are hot pink, mine are red and black stripes. It's a way that bowlers can personalize their stuff,
sure.
Things like that. Mm-hmm. And as Gretchen said, towels.
Yep.
We'll just go through this. Towel, 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 and I'm still missing one towel. So these are actually chamois towels. They actually absorb the oil a little bit better from the ball. It takes a lot less time to get the oil off the ball when you're on the approach. This is just a towel that I use for when we're using the actual ball cleaner. Gretchen had a puffball. I've got just a standard resin bag. Mountain climbers use these. That's kind of where I got mine from. The ever-present Ultra Slide, Master Slide. I also drink a lot of water when I bowl, so.
But you need to flavor it up.
But I need to flavor it up. Good. Sometimes I get the one with energy just in case I need the extra little kick.
Perfect.
If you're on a team doing league, you can play poker while you're bowling, and it's very lucrative. I won quite a bit of money this morning. If you wrist brace, let's see here. Since I also work in a pro shop, I also try to carry around a Dremel with me, just so I can sand out thumbs if they start to get a little tight or a bowler notice that they've gained some weight and their hands don't fit in the ball anymore.
Or you get like a really nasty thumbnail that you need to trim down.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Make a real quick work of this. Nail file as well, but mine is actually to file out around the thumb to make it smoother. And then when you get really advanced, you can actually have custom thumbs made for your thumbs, and they are actually removable, so they can go from ball to ball to ball. So these are also, if your thumb swells, you can change it out. If your thumb shrinks, you can change it out. Or you've got your standard ones, which mine is actually broken right now, which I need to go fix. Extra coins, change for vending machines.
Gotta keep snacked up.
Yep.
Yeah.
Pens. If you wear glasses, always make sure you carry eyeglass wipes, just in case you get laying oil on your glasses. It can be kind of a pain to get the oil off the glasses.
Off of these glasses. Oh, man. You're high maintenance.
I am.
I love it.
Bottle of aspirin, ibuprofen. I've actually got a bad knee, so I've got to take some of this before I actually bowl.
Or when you're done talking to me.
And then any little prizes that you win in bowling alley arcades.
Love it.
Yep.
Super important to the game of bowling.
Yep. They're also good luck charms, depending on the person.
Sure. Lucky duck.
Yep. That's actually what I have in mind. The only difference between the bags is yours and Gretchen's bags.
Yeah.
Everything is on the bag itself. Mine can be removed from the actual bowling ball.
I was going to say, where's your ball at?
Yep.
Yeah. Where is your ball at?
Off to the side.
Okay.
Because I did not want to lift those up onto these tables.